A musical keyboard is the set of keys found on certain musical instruments and controllers. Let's take the familiar 12 notes as an example. Each sound will have its own key. The black and white color alternation creates a pattern easy to remember. The number line is there to remind us that these tones are equally tempered. The perceived sonic distance between any two consecutive tones is always the same. Logically, the layout of the keyboard reflects this symmetry. Keys are arranged regularly. The distance between any two consecutive keys is always the same. The problem with this setup is that the keys are too small for the human hand, or if built bigger, the distance between tones is too great. This challenge can be overcome by raising every second key, allowing the lower keys to double their width. Keys are still regularly arranged. The distance between any two consecutive keys is still the same. But the upper keys are smaller and shorter. Although this may not be significant, the layout can be further improved by making the keys compact. Now all keys have the exact same shape and are symmetrical. To take it even further, stack three rows on top of each other. Every key on the vertical axis will play the same note. The many advantages created by this setup will be shortly presented. Still, the best layout has a key shape inspired by nature. The distance between the centers of any two neighboring keys is exactly the same. This compact arrangement concentrates maximum information into the smallest space. The hexagonal layout can be used just as it is, or on multiple rows to create a hexagonal version of the previous layout. But the most ingenious way of arranging keys on a musical instrument has to do with representing the pitch itself in space. Because the tones go higher and higher in pitch, the keys reflect this by being elevated an increment higher for every musical fifth and somewhat further back in the spatial layout. This pattern represents the base of an apparently complex layout. This is the Terpstra keyboard. Terpstra's geometry puts each key at a slightly different height. The layout is characterized by a vertical shift in position between the top surface of a key and the six keys surrounding it. This results in an intuitive feel for changes in pitch as your fingers move across the keyboard. By changing perspective, something very useful happens. Everything remains just as it is. The only difference is in the way we look at things. This layout is the evolution of the classic Halberstadt keyboard. And of course, an improved layout does not mean giving up the current one. By the way, this is where the black and white pattern comes from, and is by no means the only way to paint a keyboard. As you will see, the Terpstra can change the color on every key, cooler than a chameleon. Notice how the precise angle of inclination makes possible having notes an octave apart on the same horizontal axis. At the same time, the precise level of extrusion makes possible having, at the same key height, any notes an octave apart. Now let's take a look at the standard. Despite its popularity, here's why many artists consider an upgrade. Regularity is broken, to the advantage of wide keys, the C major scale. The main challenge with a standard keyboard is learning it. Triads are thought to be the building blocks of music and are basically a combination of three tones. The most popular triads are the major and the minor. Now, to learn all the major chords on the standard keyboard, a student has to memorize 12 different finger positions depending on the starting key. Let's take a few examples. Notice the patterns created. Your brain has to memorize all of them in order to make your hands play right. Although some of the patterns seem similar, they are not. Remember that you're looking at just 6 out of the total of 12 patterns used for the major chords. And there are 12 more for the minor, 12 for the augmented and 12 for the diminished, 12 for the 7th and 9th and for every other chord out there. The 6-6, also known as the balanced, symmetric, bilinear or uniform keyboard, reduces the learnable modes to just 2, depending on whether you start from a lower or upper key. Because there are 6 times fewer finger positions to remember, it is said that this makes playing the keyboard 6 times easier. The two patterns are actually the same, turned upside down. But the real breakthrough came with the Janko keyboard, who reduced the learnable modes to just 1. By stacking the keys on 3 identical rows, you have the same finger pattern for every mode, in every key, no matter where you start from. This is said to make the player learn the instrument 12 times faster. On the Terpstra, it gets even better. Because of the change in perspective, the one finger position for our major triad example can be Janko style, or, if you wish so, more close to the finger position on the standard keyboard. Programmed this way, the Terpstra keyboard encompasses 5 full octaves, each having 56 keys. And this is just one preset that comes with your new keyboard. So far, we have talked about only one way of programming the Terpstra, only one key layout. But there are more. The Terpstra is a generalized keyboard, meaning that all keys are identical in shape, and the arrangement of keys follows a regular pattern. Because there is no fixed layout, you get to decide which note is assigned to which key. The harmonic table, or sonomi, is a layout becoming increasingly popular due to its simplicity and playfulness. Other layouts for 12 notes include the wiki Haydn layout found on concertinas and the B and C systems used on some chromatic button accordions. But dividing the octave in 12 equal parts is just one of the many, many ways of tuning an instrument. The current classical keyboard, together with a tuning system based on 12 equal divisions of the octave, became somehow standardized as the only option. But there are musicians that already work with expanded tonalities. There has been progress and advancement in all areas, while concerning music, evolution has stalled. But not for everyone. The first generalized keyboard was invented in 1873 by Robert Bosanquet. His enharmonic harmonium made it possible for any passage, chord, or combination of any kind to have exactly the same form under the fingers in whatever key it was played. Irv Wilson was the first to innovate over Bosanquet. Simon Terpstra also designed his hexagonal keyboard focusing on the feel of the keys under the hands, but preserved Bosanquet's principle of elevation. Before becoming an instrument, a scale model was made out of cardboard. Every detail was fine-tuned until the feel of the keys under the fingers was right. As a practical reference tool for study, the Terpstra can easily accommodate Indian, Japanese, Indonesian, Chinese, Arabic, Turkish and Persian and any other traditional tuning systems. Whether it's just intonation, Pythagorean, well, mid-tone or syntonic temperaments, quarter tone, Harry Potter's 43 tone scale, 19, 22, 31, 53 or 55, schismatic, miracle and chest temperaments, Lucy tuning, Bowland-Pierce or tunings derived from Wilson's scale tree, golden horograms, hexanese, the coprime grid and Pascal's triangle, even the Pythagorean lambdoma, to name just a few, they are all mappable. When switching presets, changing the way notes are mapped, the keys on the Terpstra change color. More about that, together with how every key is a highly expressive continuous controller capable of sending data wirelessly to any device, and how it could output visuals based on harmonic relationships in the second part. Terpstra Keyboard's advanced features.